Hey there guys, it's your favorite backyard geographer again. You know, we've learned a lot about contour lines and maps, but have you ever wondered, how do we make a map to begin with? How do we connect those dots and make those contour lines? Well, you're in the right place. We're going to learn today how to make contour in isolines. Well, to begin, the first thing we need is a bunch of data. So what I have here is a bunch of survey markers, random elevation points, and our job is to turn this data into a map. And it's actually quite simple. The first thing we do is we need to designate what contours we would like to do. So we're going to look at the 50 foot mark, a 45 foot mark, a 40, and a 35. So the first thing we see is only 150, so this is going to be our only 50 contour line here, which is pretty simple. Remember, contour lines never cross, they never touch, they cannot go up or down in elevation, they must always remain the same point, right? Now the problem with this is that these are random elevation points, so we may not have enough to connect the dots. So we're going to have to add where they appropriately would be. So we've completed 50, let's mark that off our list. The first one's 45 that we're going to do. So the way that I do this is I actually just put a dot at all the 45s. There's one there, and there's one there, and I'm like, uh-oh, there's not enough to complete my circle, but I know that there must be additional 45s. So I can connect these two dots, because 45 goes to 45, which is excellent, and I need to complete this circle some way. Well, I know that 40 is too small, so 45 would have to go to the left of it between 40 and 50. Continuing down, 45 can only fit between 50 and 35. Continuing around again, I can continue to see where these markers would be. And then I'm able to connect my dot. So to kind of put this in retrospect, what we're looking for is the pattern that is going to be portrayed by looking at the numbers. So, you know, as an example, looking between these two elevation points, we have a 30 and a 40. That means that if this is 30 and that's 40, this must be 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, 36, 37, 38, 39, and 40. So I'm able to see where that point should belong. So it's not necessary to get, you know, every single interval on there, we're able to kind of calculate where it belongs. So I can knock off 45 off my list. My next one will be 40. So I put a dot here, I see one there, one there, one there, one there, and that's all I have. So I can easily see that because there's everything else here is lower than 40, I can easily just kind of do a nice little curve this way. Again, this is up to my interpretation because I'm not in the field, I'm not at this location. So I kind of leave my lines a little curvy. Again, 40 does not belong, it's too high of a number, but I can see there's a 40 here, and that fits appropriately, so I'm gonna just come right across to 40. Moving down, I have to fit between 45 and 35, so I'm gonna drag my line and make it real tight around here. Same thing, 40 is too high to go between these 25 and 30, so I'm gonna move my way up until I get to my next 40. Those are all too small, so I'm gonna come back and connect my line. But really, this is all about that interpretation of numbers and trying to see where it best feels right. 35 is another one I'll do. 35, 35. It's the only 35s I have, but I'm going to be able to work this out because as an example, again, 30 and then we have 40. Well, that means 35 must be in the middle. 40 to 20. Well, 35 must be closer to here. Here we have 30, which means 35 has to be here. Here, here, 40 and 30 right in the middle, a little closer here, so there's room for 30 and 20, and so on and so forth. So I'm able to go through again and connect my lines. What's interesting about this is that I'm able to observe again that idea that with contour lines, the closer the contour lines are to one another, the steeper the gradient. Through here, 20 is too small, get a little tighter, getting down to my 35, and connect my dot. So I've been able to complete a couple contour lines. So just for fun, I'm going to do 30, I'm going to do that real quick just so you can see where it goes, and I'm just going to come through here, it goes to 30, got to get it real tight right here, this is a really steep elevation on this north end of my map. Coming across, 30. 30. Found another 30. Gets a little tight here. Comes way out. And then I connect my line. We're able to observe and interpret these numbers and to create our contour lines. And again, it's really about our interpretation of the landscape. Now, it would be different if we were out in the field. We could see it and really get a better idea as to what it would look like. But just looking at raw data, this is the best that we can come up with. And I think it looks pretty good. I mean, there's some spots I could probably clean up. Maybe make this a little smoother here. But nonetheless, I think I did a pretty good job. Well, I hope this was helpful and kind of interesting in the fact of how do we complete the contour or ISO lines when drawing based on data that's been provided. Be sure to like the video where we've provided here for you. Don't forget to subscribe, comment if you have any of the questions, and we'll talk soon.